Hello everyone, welcome to CAD/CAM/CE tutorials. In the previous videos we have seen what is the numerical analysis, what are the different steps that are involved in numerical analysis. Now from this video we are going to start the numerical analysis of 1D conduction steady state heat transfer. Before going into the detail, let us first see the problem statement. So here we have to determine the steady state temperature distribution within an aluminium fin using the finite difference method. We have to assume the base temperature of the fin as 100 degrees centigrade and the tip of the fin is insulated. Initially the entire fin is at a temperature of 30 degrees centigrade. Here we will assume that the cross section area of the fin is circle having the diameter of D. So in the previous videos we have seen that there are mainly three steps involved in the numerical analysis of any engineering problem. And the first step is the formulation of the governing differential equation. So this is the first video, and in this video we are going to start the first step, that is the formulation of governing differential equation. So in order to formulate the governing differential equation for this problem, we have to use some universal fundamental laws like the law of conservation of mass and the law of conservation of energy, that is also called as first law of thermodynamics. So here we are using the energy balance, that is the law of conservation of energy. Now before going to the energy conservation or the energy balance for this problem, let us first analyze our problem. In our problem it is given that initially the fin is at a temperature of 30 degrees centigrade and suddenly we are bringing the base of the fin at 100 degrees centigrade. So as there is a temperature difference between the base of the fin and the entire fin, heat will transfer from the higher temperature to the lower temperature. And as a consequence of that, the heat will flow from the base to the tip of the fin and the temperature of the fin rises gradually. So we can see it pictorially like this. The base temperature is higher, that is TB, and the entire fin is at low temperature, and heat will gradually flow from the base of the fin to the tip of the fin. Now in order to analyze the entire problem, we have to first divide the entire fin into number of small elements. So let us assume that we are dividing the entire fin into number of small divisions, that can be seen as. Now in order to get the energy balance, we have to consider any of the element. So we'll consider an element at a distance x from the base of the fin, and then we'll perform the control volume analysis for this element. So here, as we have divided the entire fin into number of small elements, we'll see the width of this element as a dx, and here we have divided the fin into infinite number of elements, so the width of this element will be very small. So we can see that dx is approximate 0, that is dx tends to 0. Now in order to get the energy balance, we'll separate out this element from this fin. So here we can see that the left face of this element is at higher temperature, the right face is at lower temperature. So as the left face is at a higher temperature, the heat will flow into this element from the left face and heat will flow out from this element from the right face. So if we enlarge this element, we can see that this is the width of this element, that is dx, that is very small. So the volume of the fin will be dv and the mass of this element is dm. So the mass is nothing but density times volume. Now in order to get the energy balance for this element, the heat will flow from the left face and the heat will flow out from the element from the right face, and the difference of these two heat transfer will be stored into the element, and that is the rise in the energy of this element, and this rise in the energy will tends to rise in temperature of this element. Now this element is very small, so the mass of this element is dm. So we can write that the mass dm is density times volume, that is dv. Now here the volume dV is nothing but the cross section area times the thickness of this element, that is dx. So we can write dm equals to rho se dx. Now let us move to the energy balance for this element. So in general we can write that energy in minus energy out equals to energy stored by the element. But here in this case we are concerned with the rate of energy transfers. So here energy in, energy out and energy stored are taken on the rate basis. So rate of energy in minus rate of energy out equals to rate of energy stored by the element. So here in our case energy comes in as heat, that is Q dot x, energy goes out from the material as Q dot x plus dx, and the net difference in between these two will be energy stored by the element. As we know that the energy stored by the material is nothing but mcpt, but we are concerned with the rate of energy transfer and rate of energy stored. So as a consequence of the rate of energy stored, the temperature of the material rises or decreases depending on the rate of heat transfer, and so there will be change in the temperature of this element. So the rate of stored energy can be written as mcp dt by d small t. So the equation becomes q dot x minus q dot x plus dx equals to dm cp, that is the specific heat of the material, times time rate of change of temperature of this element, that is dt by d small t. Now here we know that the small mass dm of this element is rho s dx, so we can write this equation as q dot x minus q dot x plus dx equals to rho times s dx cp dt by d small t. So we'll call it as equation 1. Now if we analyze the equation number 1, then the energy that is comes into the element, that is q dot x, we can find out it from the Fourier's law of heat conduction. So our first step is to convert the heat going out from the element q dot x plus dx in terms of q dot x, and we'll do it with the help of Taylor series expansion. So the Taylor series expansion of any function f of x at f of x plus dx can be written as f of x plus derivative of f of x by 1 factorial into dx plus double derivative of f of x by 2 factorial into dx square, and so on. So here in our case we want to find out the rate of heat transfer at a distance of x plus dx with the help of rate of heat transfer at distance of f of x. So if we compare this with our situation, that we can write that f of x is q dot x and f of x plus dx is q dot x plus dx. So from the Taylor series expansion we can write that q dot x plus dx equals to q dot x plus derivative of q dot x by 1 factorial into dx plus double derivative of q dot x by 2 factorial into dx square, and so on. Now earlier we have seen that we have divided the entire fin into infinite number of elements and the length of each element is very small, that is tends to 0. So the second power, third power, fourth power and so on will be very small. So we can neglect the higher order terms and we can write that q dot x plus dx as q dot x plus derivative of q dot x by 1 factor into dx. So now we have obtained the rate of heat transfer going out from the element in terms of rate of heat transfer coming into the element. Now after getting q dot x plus dx, if we use the equation 1 and 2, then we can write that q dot x minus q dot x plus dx, that is q dot x plus q dot x dash by 1 factor into dx. So we can write that q dot x minus q dot x plus derivative of q dot x by 1 factor into dx equals to rho s dx cp into dt by d small t. Now if we open the bracket, then q dot x minus q dot x minus q dot x dash by 1 factor into dx equals to rho s dx cp into dt by d, and we can write that derivative of q dot x by 1 factor into dx equals to rho s dx cp dt by dt, and here dx gets cancelled out. So we have finally q dot x dash by 1 factorial equals to rho s cp dt by dt. Now as stated earlier that we are going to perform numerical analysis for steady state heat conduction. Steady state means that the condition of the element or the condition of entire fin should not change with respect to time. Conditions like temperature, pressure, velocity should not change with respect to time. So in case of steady state, we should have dt by d small t, that is the variation of the temperature with respect to time should be zero. That means the temperature at any location should not change with respect to time. Temperature may change with respect to the position, but temperature should not change with respect to time, and that is called as a steady state condition. So for steady state condition, dt by d small t equals to zero, and hence derivative of q dot x by 1 factorial equals to 0, and let us call it as equation number 3. Now here we can find out the heat transfer from the left face, that is q dot x, from the Fourier's law of heat conduction. So the Fourier's law of heat conduction states that the heat conducted, that is q dot x, equals to minus k ac dt by dx. So from the equation 3 and 4 we can write that derivative of q dot x by dx equals to 0. Now we are having the value of q dot x, so if we combine these two equations, we can have d by dx of minus k ac dt by dx equals to 0. In the problem statement itself, we have given that the property of the material is constant throughout the material. So we can see that the conductivity k of the material is constant throughout the material. And here in our case also, the cross section of the fin remains constant throughout the length of the fin. So we have k times ac as a constant, and we can write this equation as d by dx of dt by dx equals to 0. That means d square t by dx square equals to 0. And this is called as the governing differential equation for 1D conduction steady state heat transfer. So after getting the governing differential equation for the problem, you must have the boundary conditions for the problem to get the solution. So here we can see that the governing differential equation is of second order, so we must have two boundary conditions to solve the problem. So let us define the boundary conditions and let us see the problem. So in our problem, at x equals to 0, the temperature of the base is TB, and at x equals to L, the fin tip is insulated. So let us define the first boundary condition, that is at x equals to 0, temperature T equals to TB. The second boundary condition is that at distance x equals to L, the tip is insulated. So we can say that at the tip there is no heat transfer, that is Q dot at a distance of L equals to 0. From Fourier's law of heat conduction, we know that the heat transfer is minus K ac dt by dx, and that is 0 at x equals to L. So we can write that dt by dx at x equals to L equals to 0. So these are the two boundary conditions that are required in order to solve this problem. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you like my video, then please hit on the like button, share it, and subscribe to my channel, CADCAM CE Tutorials. Thanks.